Good morning and welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining us this morning on such short notice. I am Elizabeth Hertel, the Director of the Michigan Department of Health and Human Services. We want to share some very important information on an evolving situation happening in the Flat Rock community to which we are giving our full attention. Last week, a household in Flat Rock reported smelling a gasoline-type odor. We immediately came together with the Wayne County Health Department and the City of Flat Rock and state agencies and federal agencies to begin an investigation, focusing on an area in the southeast portion of the city and around the Hickory Ridge subdivision off Olmsted Road. The Downriver Hazmat Team, local police and fire, Public Works were on site along with the Michigan Department of Environment, Great Lakes and Energy, the Environmental Protection Agency, and the Western Wayne Hazmat Team. The odor was determined to likely be benzene related, such as gasoline. On Friday, it was determined that a storage tank had leaked gasoline in the area. Further investigation, as you know, is ongoing, with state and federal agencies working with our locals to determine if on-site material is a match for what is being found in the sewer system. We are asking residents in affected areas to evacuate until we can resolve this situation. Response teams will be going door to door immediately today to ensure that residents are informed and receive quick and accurate information about evacuation resources. We don't believe there is any imminent danger to residents at this time. However, we are acting out of an abundance of caution. Over the past week, the US EPA has measured benzene levels over 6 parts per billion in the sanitary sewers and in some homes in zone 1 of this map. Not everyone's home has been tested, and the levels in homes that have been tested may have changed. Therefore, we cannot say at this time that the air in your home is not impacted by this gasoline release. Again, if you are in zone 1 identified on the map. We do not at this time have a full understanding of how far or where this gasoline release has traveled in the sanitary sewer system. Further investigation is being sought in zone 2 to determine if this gasoline release is impacting this area. At this time, we have too little data to recommend that you evacuate. However, at this time, if you are concerned, you can get assistance to relocate while this investigation is going on. We want people to know that we are aggressively mobilizing to collect the necessary data to address the situation. The investigation will include testing of the air in homes to ensure that no benzene hazards from this release remain in your home. This type of testing is complex, does take some special equipment and some time to implement. The planning is still underway, but we do know that we will be requesting specialty equipment to Flat Rock to expedite this effort. Even with these efforts, this testing may take weeks, depending on how quickly we can mobilize. At this time, I would like to introduce Mr. Mayor Mark Hammond to go into some of the details on the evacuation. Following that, Dr. Caldoun will speak on some of the effects on benzene, and then we will take some questions from the press. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Tell. I'm Mark Hammond. I'm the mayor of the city of Flat Rock. We've been working jointly since Tuesday, Ms. Hartel talked about, with this hazard that we've discovered in our community. I'd like to reiterate for the residents that are listening out there and also the media, this appears to be only a Flat Rock event. Because of the prompt action of our wastewater treatment people, our first responders, the area seems to be isolated to areas 1 and 2 of the initial impact. However, additional testing is necessary to confirm those statements. We are going to assist the Department of Health and Human Services in the evacuation of the Flat Rock residents. You're our people. We want to take care of our people. We are going to be going door to door with information packets, and we're going to record your information as the residents and community members in the city, and we're going to keep in contact with you during the evacuation. We will also provide the service to contact you when the Department of Health and Human Services with the EPA and Eagle to return to your homes. So that communication will come from us, and we will make sure that you're updated whenever possible. The sewer lines currently are clear of volatile materials. In English, that means the flammability levels of the gasoline are no longer present. Now we're moving into the next phase of, as Dr. Calhoun will explain, the hazards of the benzene, which is a product in gasoline. If you have questions, we'll take those at the end. Again, thank you very much. I really appreciate the residents of Flat Rock being so cooperative. We've been in your homes at midnight, 2 a.m, making sure that you're safe. We do have 12 homes that are evacuated this time, including one charter school, and we are working diligently to keep those people informed and to keep them in our thoughts and prayers, and we want to make sure that they're taken care of. So as this continues, if we have additional evacuations, precautionary evacuations, we're going to make sure that they're taken care of as well. Thank you, and now I'd like to introduce Dr. Calhoun.
Good morning. Thank you so much, Mr. Mayor, Director Hertel. I'm going to speak briefly about some of the potential health impacts of benzene, in particular, associated with benzene exposure. So benzene is a flammable and colorless liquid. It has a sweet odor, and it's frequently used to make many chemicals. It can actually be found in gasoline, crude oil, tobacco smoke, actually, and it's used to make synthetic materials, lubricants, dyes, and detergents. So outdoor air actually generally contains low levels of benzene, again, from tobacco smoke. It can come from gas stations, motor vehicle exhaust, and industrial emissions. Indoor air generally contains levels of benzene that are higher than those in outdoor air, and the benzene in indoor air can come from products that contain benzene, such as glues, paints, furniture wax, and detergents. So breathing in very high levels of benzene can actually cause people to feel symptoms within minutes to several hours of exposure. And those symptoms can include headaches, you can feel dizzy, you can feel weak, you can have a rapid heart rate, or you can feel very drowsy or sleepy. At very, very high levels, exposure to benzene can cause death, but based on what we've seen, thus far in our response, we have not seen benzene levels in the homes tested at that level. So the main impact of long-term exposure to benzene, particularly over a year I'm talking about now, is on the blood. So it can cause low blood cell counts or anemia. It can cause a weakened immune system, and it can cause blood cancer. Again, I'm talking about long-term exposure. So out of an abundance of caution, as has been mentioned today, MDHHS is currently recommending that people who are at risk of being exposed to 6 parts per billion or higher levels of benzene in the air evacuate while we do our due diligence and work with our partners to understand the risk of exposure more. That number specifically is based on studies that looked at potential health risks of exposure for 2 weeks to benzene in particular. So it's also important to note that benzene leaves the bloodstream very quickly after someone has been exposed. So a test for benzene can't actually tell you if you've been exposed for how long or what the potential health impacts of that exposure may be. So essentially, there's not really a test. There's also no known specific treatment for benzene exposure, and really the best thing is to remove someone from the exposure risk. So if someone is experiencing symptoms like headache, rapid heart rate, dizziness, some of those things that I described, they should absolutely contact their medical provider to seek an evaluation. And to be clear, having these symptoms does not necessarily mean that you have been exposed to benzene. Some of those symptoms I described are very general, and many things can cause them. However, if you are having these symptoms and you are concerned, you absolutely should seek evaluation by a medical provider. So as has been mentioned, this is a continually evolving situation. As our partners and as MDHHS learns more, we will absolutely be certain to update the public about what we know and what you all should do to protect yourselves. Our primary concern, our main goal here, is to protect the people of Flat Rock and to do our due diligence from a public health and technical perspective to protect all of you. So thank you. With that, I think I'll turn it back over to Laura.
Thank you so much, Dr. Caldoun. So at this point, we can take a few media questions, if there are any. Yes. What? I'm sorry, who are you with?
I'm sorry. Jason Allen from the NewsHail. Question for Mark, please. At the last press conference, you mentioned that there were no reported illnesses or deaths. Has that changed now?
I'm sorry, the question was again? I'm sorry.
At the last press conference, you reported there were no reported illnesses or deaths.
That is correct. That remains the same. There have been no reported illnesses, and thank God there's been no deaths.
Is there another question? Yep.
Hi.
Oh, yep.
Eric with Channel 4. We're getting reports of loved ones that work at the plant. Are they being are they in any dangerous conditions working there right now?
I think that's a local question about the Ford plant.
I guess I drew the short straw. I don't have the answer to the tactics and strategy that the Ford plant is using, but they're following OSHA as the requirement that has, and they're having aggressive health and safety for their employees. I don't think the plant's operational at this time, but they are looking, I'm sure that by law they're looking out for the health and safety of their employees, but I don't, as far as the activities go, that's going to have to be directed to Ford Public Relations. We don't have that information. I'm sorry.
Okay. And people, you know, for people that can't evacuate, they may, for whatever reason, are there things they can do to minimize the danger?
Again, I'll say it's usually it becomes more concentrated if it's indoor. So if you do think that you may be exposed, it's good to open windows or to go outdoors if you cannot evacuate. Benzene does tend to leave the body, as I said, pretty quickly after you've been exposed, but outdoor is certainly better as far as ventilation for mitigating exposure risk. And I don't know if Corey, you want to come up?